Hello, my name is Roland van Oostveen. I'm an associate professor of education here at the Faculty of Education at University of Ontario Institute of Technology. My research focuses on studying interactions between human beings as mediated by computers. So essentially what I'm looking at is studying virtual environments and individuals actually interacting through those virtual environments. I'm interested in creating scenarios that are real world, that are open-ended, and that are ill-structured. The real world refers to instances where they are richly depicted, usually using video-based case studies. And what I'm interested in is depicting as close to reality outside of a particular setting as I possibly can. And that's in order to allow for people to position themselves so that they recognize the settings, the context that are being depicted, and so that they can actually see the motivation that's involved with it, as compared to problems that are usually presented to learners in structured learning environments, i.e. classrooms, that are usually abstracted from the real world. They are very, very much closed in from the perspective that they don't have the richness of detail, so that the focus is on only the one problem that's actually being presented. The open-endedness talks about the fact that for most problems in life, there is no one solution. There are a multiplicity of solutions that we can create as we're going. So what I'm trying to do is build into these environments that realness so that people can actually create their own responses, their own solutions as they're going forward. I don't believe that knowledge can actually be transferred from one individual to another. Information can be communicated, transferred from one person to another, but the way that we actually make sense out of that information is highly idiosyncratic. It has to do with the way we are, the kinds of backgrounds that we've got, the experiences that we've had, and the way that we've actually structured the way our mind is going to be able to work as a result of all of those experiences. Since this day and age has turned out to be one in which we have a glut of information, so no longer can the teachers think about themselves as being the purveyors of or the gatekeepers of information or access to information, but we need to now start working on how do you make sense out of all the information that you have available to you. So this mechanism that I have of taking a look at problems and trying to identify the problems, come up with the solutions based on the experiences of the individuals who are involved, and this collaboration negotiation that we have between individuals has the potential to revolutionize, I hope, the way that we take a look at education, whether it be at the K-12 kind of setting or at higher education levels, et cetera. There are also possibilities for new means of professional learning or professional development, because most of my work is, to the present day anyways, focused on adult learning, so at the higher education kind of level. But there's corporate training that would be involved, service organizations that need to take a look at how can we actually improve standards amongst individuals, and you do that, I believe, by encouraging discourse on particular topics and then structuring that discourse.